Still pretty wound out. You know, we travel all about playing music, and last summer we went out west.
I did.
If you've ever traveled out there, it's just a whole different ball game, especially once you hit the flat ground out there. And the sky gets real big, and it's just all around you circling. And you're driving, and you see a mountain range off in the distance, and 3 hours later, you're still looking at that same mountain range as you keep driving towards it. It gives you a lot of time to think about stuff. So I was driving out there wondering, you know, what was it like for the very first dudes that made this trip out here? And when they saw all this for the first time, and what were they thinking about? And I thought, well, after we got there, what do we wind up doing, and what is it now? And I'm not, it's not a judgment call. I'm not saying that it's messed up or anything. It's just, it's a little different than it was. Ian, could you give me just a touch of an electric guitar and a wedge? Just a touch. There we go. That's beautiful. Thank you. Ian back here on board for this evening, doing a great job. Thank you, sir. So I wrote this little number about going out there. It's called Go West, Young Man. We'll be right back.
The
name of the group is Laid Back Country Picker. And we're here. And we're here for you, brother. Thanks for coming out. Yeah! We've been out, we started off in Charlotte on Monday, and I don't know where we was last night. But we're here tonight, and we're so happy to be here. Got some old friends come up from down Kentucky to see us. Got new friends we made from Maryland. Yeah. You are from Maryland, are you?
Yes, sir.
You know, I was telling him, we played up where he's from here a while back. It was a nudist colony we played at up there. And you know, when you're in high school, you think, man, that would be the ultimate gig. Let's go play a gig at a nudist colony. I'm just going to tell you, it wasn't as cool as you think it is. And they told us, they said, you guys can play nude too if you want to. I said, no, we're probably good. But it just got a little bit funky. And he assured me that he has no affiliation with the nudist colony whatsoever. You know, Nixon said he didn't do anything wrong as well.
That's true.
I was born in 1964 in Lawrence County, Kentucky, which makes me a Sagittarius, being born in November, the most philosophical of all signs.
No.
Well, maybe not. But I grew up, my formative years were in the 1970s, and that was a great time to be a child and to come of age, because the 70s was the brown decade, if you think about it. It was a brown decade. Everything was brown, except for refrigerators, which were green. And green refrigerators still exist to this day, and I'm sure there's garages full of beer kegs with green refrigerators right now that will run until the end of time. I had a lot of heroes when I was growing up in the 70s. One of the people I thought was the coolest on earth was a man named Muhammad Ali. Because Muhammad Ali could whip anybody, except Joe Frazier sometimes. Another hero of mine was Evel Knievel. Evel Knievel would jump anything, fearless. Another hero of mine was Farrah Fawcett Majors, for no real reason. But my dad thought that was all foolishness. He said, son, look at a man like John Glenn. Now that's somebody to look up to, a true American hero. He was asked to do stuff for his country, and he just said, let's go. Whatever you need, I got you. So I thought about that, and I wanted to write this song, coupled with the fact that about 3 years ago, I was in Atlanta, Georgia, at the Driving and Crying Rock concert, And in between bands, there was an old drum girl on the front rail. And while we're waiting on driving the crowd to come out, she would turn around and look at the crowd and yell, "Amen, John Glenn!" And that was it. And she would just turn back around. 10 minutes later, she would turn around and do the same thing. So I got my phone out, I swear to God, and I typed that phrase in. I said, "That's a badass phrase. Amen, John Glenn." So I checked it out to make sure it wasn't already a song, and it wasn't. So I wrote one, and here's a song I made up called "Amen, John Glenn." Oh, years up in upstate New York here before the pandemic. I don't know, everything just before the pandemic to me. I can't put a time to it.
Yeah, that's right.
We were trying to get home. We'd been up there watching Town Mountain play some music, I think. And we're coming back home, and we're coming through West Virginia. We'd been out too long and just not eating good and not sleeping right. And just, you get weird after a while. And we drove through this town called Weston, West Virginia. Weston is the home of the Carp Festival. So if you like to catch carp, that's where you need to go. And we all do. And driving through Weston, it was just one of those moments of clarity. They were playing, the FM radio station played Moon Age Daydream by David Bowie, and everything just hit me just right. And I told Honey, I said, "Honey, you're about to pull over," and she didn't say anything. Thanks, somebody.
Not saying anything now, is she?
No, she's not. So I got her to stop at the Dairy Queen, and I asked the waitress for a piece of paper, and I wrote this song. And I put it on my first record, which I got over here, and I'll tell you everything I got here in a minute. And people listen to it, and they speculate, and they say, "Well, I think I know what that song's about. I think that song is about glam rock." And I said, "No, it's really nothing about glam rock." And other people say, "Well, that song is clearly about venture capitalism." No, not really that. And others say, "Well, I think that song is about psychedelic drug use." We'd like to do it for you right now. It's called Dave Bowie. Taking some calls, and the phone rings, and there sure is a dude named Ian Anderson on the flute. I've never seen anybody get so excited about Ian Anderson. Wait a minute, there is a guy named Jay Giles in that band. But he don't do no singing, that'd be Peter Wolf. The dude had me. I said, brother, you won. And he said, I never even brought up the Marshall Tucker Band or Bobby Hatchett. But while I got you on the phone, do you think you might play Spanish Casual Magic by Jimi Hendrix?
Some people lived on the West Virginia side. Actually, it was just one person who lived over there. And a lot of gentlemen who lived on the Kentucky side. And so This song's really just about a transaction. So in the middle of the pandemic, we recorded a record called Kingsport. about Kingsport, Tennessee.
Yeah,
and we didn't know what to do with it because we couldn't really tour behind it to promote it, but then I had it sitting there in my house and I wanted to do something with it, so we put it out. And it just kind of went in the black hole that everything went to during COVID. But we're going to play a couple of songs off it. Thank you for that. And I got some copies over here. Once again, if you don't drink all your money up, I'll sell you a bunch of stuff. Some people were smart. I keep all this stuff really what you do. Here's a song I made up called Kingsport.
It's a fire with an owl.
You know, thinking of Johnny Cash, I made up this song. Here about a month ago, I was watching the news, and they come on, they said there was a really bad truck wreck up in Pennsylvania. And the driver lost most of his load up there. And it turns out this guy was hauling a load of monkeys. A whole truckload of monkeys, and he wrecks, and it just scatters the monkeys all over the place. And then they came on the TV, and they said, please avoid the area, and if you go up there, don't try to catch these monkeys. We got them. You just leave them alone. And I just had so many questions. First off, why is this guy hauling a truckload of monkeys? And even better, where do you get a truckload of monkeys at? And where's he taking them, and what are they going to do with them?
Hold up.
Or have they already done something to them? And why don't you want us to try and catch them? So I just couldn't figure all this out. So I had to write a song, so I start putting this song together about it. And naturally it turns into a truck driving song because he's hauling a load of monkeys. And I kept writing it, and it turned into a really nice part. So this song ain't got anything to do with monkeys at all. It's called Down the Road. toes and kept them on their toes. Yeah!
Today.
I may spin you off a copy on cassette and bring it up to you. You still doing cassette?
Cassette.
Oh, we can do CDs. Hey, no kidding, this record will be out on 8-track. And here's what I'm going to do. I already got it figured out. I'm going to go to the flea markets. I'm going to buy every 8-track I can for $1. And I got an 8-track recorded. I'm just going to dub them over top Conway 20 8-tracks, and I'm going to sell them. Why not? And if you get to the end of it, you get a little bit of Conway at the end. Who wins right there? We all do.
I have Charlie Daniels on my channel. I got cassette.
Mark.
Charlie Daniels.
Maybe we'll do some Jimmy Martin.
That's what I'm saying. You have no idea who I am.
I don't know. I'm out of Martin. Dean Martin. We'll do some Dean Martin. We'll do some Lee Marvin. Oh, it's not Martin. Man, I'm going to play y'all 3 or 4 more numbers and go home. I know y'all got stuff to do besides sit out here. What is this? This is Wednesday night. What's on TV tonight? Is that it? Well, you didn't pay the cable bill. That's why you're here. That's cool. I like you guys, man. Thank you so much. Actually, I like everybody in this room right now. Give yourselves a hand for coming out. I'm just curious. How many of y'all have to go to work in the morning?
No!
Yeah! There's a song I made up about where it's a road down where I live. I think you'll dig it the most. We'll be right back. Apologies to Jimmy Page on that last number right there. Hey, you're the man. Right along. Hey, we got a request from a man that drove a long way to be here. We're going to do this song for you. We've been playing this for a while, but we're going to do it for you, brother. If it goes south, let's just pretend like it never even happened. What's that company that comes in, they clean your house like it never even happened? Is that, maybe they only do that where we come from. Is that who it is?
Everything's respected a lot.
Okay. Aristocoms. Like, Service Pro. It's Service Pro. Like it never even happened. You guys are probably wishing this never even happened.
What?
I love you, man. Hey, is there any trailers for rent up here? I may just move up here. Just move to Roanoke. If I get a good 12 to 60 somewhere, I'd be set up.
That's all I know.
That's all. I'm trying to think of this song. It's a good song if I can remember. Oh, I got it. I drove a red Carmageddon down to Seoul, South Korea. They said, well, what's it all mean? I said, well, Dong Chao Ping. I drove a straight six gremlin down through the halls of the Kremlin. You know that they don't care to cuss you down in old Soviet Russia. But they'll come and take your country if you ain't careful. Victoria. The flagship of the fleet of the Ford Motor Company, as far as I'm concerned. Their finest hour. And of course, they quit making them. When I got that car, my buddies down home said, well, there, laid back, you done got you a McGoffin County Cadillac. And I didn't really know what that meant. But my neighbors over in McGoffin County, there's a bunch of good union boys down there. They're millwrights and they're laborers and there's electricians and welders. And they get those cars so they can put all their buddies in the back and they drive to work and jobs like in Lexington and Toyota and they just drive all their friends to work. And they're great because these cars get about 25 miles a gallon. You can haul a bunch of people in the back. And they go super fast. But the most important thing is, out there on the front of the car is the big silver spotlight out there. Which is pretty much your free pass to do whatever. Because you can be hammered down the road about 80, and you pass the cop and they see that and they just go, and they just keep right on going and everything's cool. So I got me a McGoffin County Cadillac and I found out what it meant. I love everybody in McGoffin County. I love everybody in Roanoke tonight, I'm telling you. And if you ain't seen the video for this, go Google McGoffin County Cadillac because it stars Honey back here on the drums. One more time, I just love her to death, so let's hear it for Honey. She did not. I love y'all. Hey, it's time for us to quit, but I would like to play one more song, if that's okay.
Yeah!
I won't put you through all that showbiz stuff where I act like we're done and you we do it. Let's just lay that to the side. I'm going to do you, this will be our last song. Hey, well, I love you. I'm going to do a cover of a 1970s rock song, and I'm not sure which one it'll be yet. Tell the truth here. Let's take a little poll. Are you more on the rock and roll side, or are you more on the country side? How many people's on the country side? Let's hear you.
Yeah!
On the rock and roll side. All right, I got it. How about this dude? Where you at, brother?
Country!
Country music. Oh, we can play both of them and be done with it.
Southern rock!
70s rock.
Country rock.
Southern rock. This is a folk song right here. Some buddies of mine from up New York wrote this. I try to play some country music, some rock music, some folk music, because folk music's important. It tells stories about people who often were just viewed with the wrong eye out in public. And the folk singers like Woody Guthrie tried to make it all right. So these boys are a fine bunch of folk musicians, and I'm going to sing a song that they wrote about somebody that's very misunderstood. Thank you guys for coming out with us tonight. Come and see us again. We'll be at the merch table. We'll sell you some stuff. We'll take some pictures. I love y'all.